Hello guys and welcome to Survival Russia. So today I'm basically out scavenging the woods a little bit for birch bark and I need some pine branches to make something with, make a video on actually, of course. And then for the first time ever, I actually met someone not far from this camp and he actually found this camp, you can say. It was a hunter from the nearby village, of the homestead there. Yeah, so that was pretty weird. I didn't know him. I just asked him where he was from. He said he was from the village there, and I said, okay, I'm from the homestead up there, and said, yeah, I know. I didn't know him, he knew me. Anyway, today's video is of course about silky saws. Because I often get the question, what is your favorite silky saw? What's your favorite saw? What's your favorite saw? And that's a little bit like asking, what's your favorite knife? I don't, it depends on what it's been has to be used for, right? If I'm getting asked what is my favorite saw for staying hot or warm, making a fire and so on in the winter, then I will definitely say the Katana Boy 500. Because that's a beast, it's a lifesaver when it comes to that. But for general use, my two Gumboy saws is what I prefer. So let's take a look at those. And we're mainly gonna take a look at the Gumboy 240 with the curved blade. Saws are important now. It's autumn, winter's coming, fire and wood processing is gonna be more important than ever. So here we have the silky Gumboy 240 with the curved blade. These holsters here, they are actually not too shone at. They're quite sturdy. I actually managed to, last winter, to step on this guy here and the lid came off and I thought, dang, it's broken, but it's not. It just broke off this little plastic hinge and as I most likely, hopefully, will be able to demonstrate it, it comes back on pretty easy. Now we are on camera, so it will most likely not come back on pretty easy. There we go. Okay, we have a funky loop here, which is sort of like a belt loop, and it hooks on to two slots up here, or grooves, or what we can call them. This might be fine if you are a gardener or arborist or something. But I would certainly not recommend using this as the primary carry option, or what you can say, or way of carrying the saw here. Basically you can say the more pressure that's applied in this direction here, the more these two rubber hooks dig into the grooves here. So yeah, it seems pretty sturdy actually, but yeah, I would not rely on it. Anyway, you flip this to the side, and flip the lid off. The lid also closes, but yeah, flip the lid up, we have the saw. The saw is like any other silky saw. It has a really, really sturdy locking or bolt here, you can say. And it has a sturdy locking mechanism. There are only one setting. Some saws have two settings. Anyway, you can see this guy here has a curved blade. This Gumboy 270, which means that the blade is 270 millimeters long and not 240 millimeters like this guy here, I use a lot. This saw here has 10 teeth per inch. The curved blade here has 8 teeth per inch. And I would say this saw here with an 8 TPI, as it's called, blade, would be really, really awesome for softer woods like birch, pine, whatnot. The 270 here is most likely the saw I use the most together with this saw. This size here is really, really good for the outdoors. One awesome feature about this saw here is that this blade here actually is made for also rip cutting, meaning cutting along the grain and not only cross grain. And this can be very, very, very useful for building shelters, and especially if you need to, in an emergency, rehaft an axe. Because if you need to rehaft an axe, you of course need to cut a slit, or what we can say, a groove for the wedge, right? So which one is the best of these? It's It's really difficult to say. As I say, it all depends on what do you want to use the saw for, right? I mean, this saw here is really, really awesome for cutting thicker branches and not too big logs. I'll show you in a second, but what I mean. Also, the awesome thing about Silky is that they do not make saws for the outdoors. Actually, they make them for professional gardeners and arborists. So they are not trying to, you can say, to dig in on the outdoors market, or what you can say. They already have a number one choice among arborists, I'm pretty sure. So that's where their business are. These saws just happen to be exceptionally well cutting and sharp, so they're of course really good for the outdoors. This guy here is made for when you have to reach up high, that the curved blade here will give you a little bit better bite. I'll show you in a second. I can see the lighting is not the best, but up here we have some dead pine branches, and I need some dead pine branches. I need at least one, so let's try and take it with this guy here, because that's what it's made for. It gives a good bite on the last bit here, where a straight blade would be not so awesome, because it's of course a little bit difficult to apply pressure when you're standing like this, right? Yeah, I'm sorry, we have wind and logging trucks are busy and whatnot, but I basically just need this little piece here. And what I mean is that when you are pulling the saw, because it's curved, it sort of like stops you from pulling the saw all the way through the branch here. So the curved blade here is not as great as the straight blade when you have to cut something that is of a really large diameter according to the size of the blade, or compared to the size of the blade. Then the straight blades are better. However, the Gumboy 240 here with the curved blade, it will still cut fairly thick logs, you can say. I would guess it should be capable of cutting this guy here with relative ease. And how I cut when I have to cut thicker logs is I hold out here and I put my hand over here so I can apply pressure while pulling. Don't put the hand on the log, of course, but that's how I do it, like this. So I will not apply too much pressure on the stroke forwards, but on the on pulling I will. Under tension, hopefully not too much. Like that. I'll try and make a disc here. So it can of course process fairly all right firewood, no problem. If you want to cut larger logs for larger Siberian log fire, this is a little bit better, but it has 10 TPI, 8 TPI would be awesome. But what I just cut here, it will provide a fine fire. All this wood here, I of course cut with the big Katana Boy. Yeah, the big Katana Boy is of course in a league of its own. But the Gumboy series here is definitely my series of go-to saws. The Super XL is also nice, but I actually lost that one. Embarrassing. The Pocket Boy 170 is an awesome small saw that can easily outcompete most other saws, especially the Laplander, of course. So yeah, it all depends on what you need to use the saw for. I'll say, for all-round saw where you do not have to rely on cutting real trees, you know, like this stuff here, then I would prefer the Gumboy 240 with the curved blade, because it can also rip cut, as I say. Awesome feature. So guys, I hope you liked the video. I hope you found the information about what's my favorite go-to saw. So yeah, please take links in the description. I hope you will support the channel and subscribe, so bell, so like, and all that good stuff. Until next time, get out and train, get it done, do something awesome. See you in the next one, guys. Thank you for your time.